Hi, I'm Carl Schultz, president of Pacline Corporation, and we're here today in Pacline's War Room, and we're going to talk about the most common method we use for hanging our systems from the ceiling of a building. And we're going to talk about all the different components, how they go together, and we're going to look at least two different arrangements for installing using standard off-the-shelf water pipe. So all of the things that we're going to talk about today can be found in Pacline's safety and installation manual. When you buy a system from us, you get this manual. Can't miss it. It's bright orange so that it can't be misplaced very easily. It says safety and installation manual on the side. Within it, we have written instructions. First thing, you have to read this manual before you install a system. There are things that that need to be done. There's safety precautions and safety features of our hanging methods which have to be followed closely, or else something bad can happen. Within this manual, there is an engineering section up front. It shows how to design a system. If you've bought something from us already and we were the ones who designed it, this has already all been taken into account. And behind the engineering pages, there are the actual engineered drawings. So for every component that's made, there is a drawing. In here as well, we have a variety of different installation attachments. For example, here's a sleeve, which is used along with the pipe that you can buy from any plumbing store in the area, and construct a system used to hang our equipment from the ceiling of a building. We've chosen to come into Pacline's war room because it just so happens that this room is constructed with open web steel joists. This is the most common ceiling structure that we find, and so we've manufactured many components that will allow you to connect directly to it. So you can see here that an open web steel joist is constructed of angle iron and round bar, but it leaves the web open, which is where it gets its name from, open web steel joist. So if you have an opportunity to connect to an open web steel joist, this is your easiest and best method for attaching the upper portion of the hanging system. We manufacture spade bolts, threaded spade bolts, which have a bolt hole on the bottom. We have a pair of truss plates, and we will sandwich the open web steel joist within this. So we'll try and get this up through. Through like this. We'll put top part on and then attach the threaded rod sandwiching so we're sandwiching the open web steel joist. I'd like to say right now that every bit of hardware that is used in these systems should be sized properly, and they should be have locking nuts or lock washers to secure them. You don't want this to vibrate loose over the years. So you can see all of these nuts have lock washers behind. So from here, we can now attach a variety of different attachments to the bottom of it to carry the system. If we have a quick look at the various components laid out on the floor in front of us here, you'll get the idea of how this will, in the end, end up. In the trusses, we have a couple of different components we're going to use. Either one of these components could have been substituted with the threaded rod that we just showed you. On the lower end, we have the track hanger. It's a TH300 track hanger clamp, which comes with this portion and a sleeve. This portion has an additional bit called a sway brace attachment with its own sleeve. And these pipes that are used to support the system, once again, are standard 3/4 inch ID water pipes. You can get them at any hardware store. They come in galvanized or black. And they'd be cut to length to suit. The attachments themselves have a leveling set screw. These do not support the load. I warn you, you cannot support the load using these. These are simply used to allow you to adjust the length of the pipe within the sleeve. And once it is set, you tighten these and drill a hole through the side and apply a through bolt. Once again, in this case with a nylocked locking nut. And that will go through and support the load. You do not support any load with these. So we're going to go ahead and attach to this open web joist using a beam clamp this time. Now, you know we have open web steel joists here, but if we did not have open web steel joists and we just had the bottom flange of some type of beam, we could use Pacline's BC300 beam clamp. I'm going to show how to attach a beam clamp to the beam itself. So I've disassembled this unit, and I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to put this across here. As you can see, there is a lot of extra threaded rod on this beam clamp, and that will allow me to attach this beam clamp to a number of different widths of beam. When tightened, you can see the hook bolt is over this side, and this part of the beam clamp is over this side, forming a secure holding point. So we're going to install first the track hanging clamps that will support the track, which is of course somewhere around this elevation. We'll start with that so that we can get the track up, and then add sway braces afterwards to secure the system so that it can't move sideways. So we start by taking the standard pipe. We cut it approximately to length. We don't need to have it exact at this point because the set screw and sleeve allow some movement up and down to achieve the final exact track elevation that we want. So I take the pipe, slide it into the sleeve, and I would tighten that set screw. Then I would take the other end of the track clamp. That would be, right now we have a track clamp with a sway brace attachment already on it. We can take this portion off and just hang the track. But we would do this, slide it over the end, just roughly position the track, tighten the set screws, and then fine level the system. So now we would lay these track hanger clamps out, put a section of track within, and then check the elevation. Move it up or down as required. So now that we would have a long length of track supported, we could go ahead and add the sway braces. Sway braces can be used, or generally are used, every second track hanger. We like to position these track hangers on no greater than 8 or 9 foot centers. Typically they're 6 to 7 feet, but that's totally load dependent. So Pacline engineers will tell you how that should be supported. It's better to have more support than less support. Every second track hanger clamp, TH300 track hanger clamp, could have a sway brace on it. So you can see here that this sway brace will be set up such that we have another piece of pipe coming off to the side, thereby resisting the sideways forces on this track. So I'm going to go ahead. You can see here that we don't have anything to attach to. So we're going to add a piece of header steel to that. We're going to run a piece of header steel across now from one open web steel joist to the other. I have cut to length here a piece of 1.5 inch ID water pipe. We use these quite often for the header steel when we're doing this style of system, this pipe style of hanging system. So I'm going to feed this over top of the trusses. All right, so we have cut a piece of header steel to fit between the open web steel joists. And you can see here how it is going to be sitting on this flange of the open web steel joist. I have slid one of my header steel clamps over top. And you can see how it will, now when I tighten this down, it will firmly hold the header steel on top of the flange of this open web steel joist. So we're going to go ahead and tighten that up. It's important, once again, to only use lock nuts or nylock. Okay, so now we have secured the header steel pipe to the open web steel joist, or whatever the beam is. And now we've provided a convenient place to attach our sway brace. So we have another attachment that goes over top of the pipe. We're going to go ahead and attach that like that. And you can see that, rotate this around, this sleeve will fit in between. And now we have almost completed our installation setup. So we have now assembled the complete hanger with a sway brace attached. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to secure the system. We're going to make sure that these are perfectly straight up and down, the track hanger portion of it. And then we will make sure all of the set screws are tightened, and then we're going to drill holes through. So for the purpose of this, I'm not going to drill holes, but just to show you, we have drilled a couple of holes here just to show that this will be put through. This through bolt will secure the load, will hold the load, it'll carry all the weight. And once again, we're using locking nuts on everything here. Every one of these connections has a lock nut on it. And that basically explains how we use pipe to hang our systems. So that's the pipe method of securing our systems. There's also a possibility to use angle iron, which some people like to use. Pacline manufactures a number of different attachments for using that method. And in our engineering manual, you'll be able to see both methods in one drawing. We've done the pipe method, but over on the other side of the drawing is the angle iron method of securing the system. Either one can be used. This one just happens to be the more common, and quite honestly, it looks best. It's the better looking installation. So, once again, we would ask that you thoroughly review the installation manual that comes with your system, or if necessary, you can get it at our website, which is www.pacline.com. Review that first. Ask Pacline's engineers for any assistance that you might need. Don't do anything that you're uncomfortable with. Get advice. When you look through this drawing manual, you'll see that there are a number of different attachments that you can purchase from us. So your installation may not be exactly as you thought, so you need to make a change. By all means, you can select items out of that book, get a price on it, and delivery. We generally manufacture everything to stock, to inventory, so that you can pull from that. So we're just a day courier charge away from getting you the parts you might need in the event that something unforeseen comes up. At this point, we would go around and double check the whole system, make sure that it's adequately braced throughout. And then when you start up the system, you may find that there's a vibration in one area or another causing an unsightly movement of the conveyor. Maybe it's not a problem, but if you don't like the way it appears, then you could add these sway braces in any number of areas. You can also use one of our wall brace attachments if you were up so close to the wall that it didn't make sense to use header pipe or connect to another truss. You could use lag bolts and connect it to a concrete wall that's adjacent to the conveyor system. Anyway, all of those things are explained in the installation manual, and so take the time to read it, and we wish you luck on your installation. Thank you.